So I want to just do a few problems involving the derivatives of logs so we can see those. So we start out talking about the basic derivative of a log, of the natural log. So if I have a function f of x equal natural log of x, then f prime of x, the derivative of that is 1 over x, when just x is this argument, or what is in the inside the parentheses. Okay, so let's do an example. Find h prime of x for h of x is equal to natural log of x over x squared. So this is a problem where I either need to use the product rule or quotient rule, something like that. I'll use the quotient rule because I have an x in the numerator and an x in the denominator, right? So I have the top of that is natural log of x, and the derivative of the top is 1 over x. The bottom, the denominator is x squared, and the derivative of the bottom is 2x. Okay, and then the quotient rule says h prime of x is the bottom times the derivative of the top minus the top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. So let's go ahead and plug in these pieces. X squared times 1 over x minus natural log of x times, let's see, 2x, right? Over, oh, x squared was the original thing in the denominator, and I square that, so I'll get an x to the fourth. Here, this first term on top, one of these x's will cancel, so I'm left with just x minus 2x natural log x over x to the fourth. I can factor an x out of that in the numerator. X times 1 minus 2 times natural log of x, because I factored the x out, x to the fourth, and this x will cancel, so I get, with one of the x's in the denominator, 1 minus 2 natural log of x over x cubed. Okay? That's utilizing this derivative of the natural log. Okay, so now of course we want to talk about a function, h of x, this big function, remember, which is the natural log of some other function, g of x, inside here, right? Where this has this and is a composite function. And I go back to this general chain rule. So I have this chain rule, which says if h of x is some function f of g of x, then h prime of x is f prime of g of x times g prime, right? That's the rule that we have. In this particular case, natural log is this outside function, this wrapper function. Here, this f of x is this natural log function. Okay? So in this case, when I take the derivative here, then h prime in this particular case should be f prime of the original inside times g prime of x. But I know what f prime is, right? When f of x is equal to the natural log of x, f prime of x is equal to 1 over x, right? So I have this is 1 over, and I put in g of x times g prime of x for this particular case, okay? So when, let me do this in another color so you can see it. When h of x equals the natural log of g of x, then h prime is equal to 1 over g of x times g prime of x. Just like that. Okay? So I want to do an example problem. Just a simple. So find f prime of x when f of x is equal to the natural log of 5x. So in this case, this inside piece, this g of x is equal to 5x, right? And so I know that f prime of x is equal to 1 over g of x times g prime of x. So I'll get, and here let me just calculate real quick. G prime of x is 5, so I get 1 over 5x times 5. The 5's cancel, and I just get 1 over x here. Okay? Let's do a slightly more complicated problem. Find f prime for f of x is equal to natural log of 2x cubed minus 5x plus 1. Okay? And again, this in this case, my g of x's inside function is this 2x cubed minus 5x plus 1, and g prime is equal to 6x squared minus 5, right? Okay? So when I put that in, so f prime of x is equal to 1 over this g of x times g prime of x using this chain rule. So I get 1 over 2x cubed minus 5x plus 1 times 6x squared minus 5. And I will probably just write that as 6x squared minus 5, these parentheses here in the numerator, and 2x cubed minus 5x plus 1 in the denominator. But that's your answer for the derivative. Okay? I want to do just one more, because otherwise these are just applying these kind of new rules for derivatives here. Find f prime of x for f of x is equal to the natural log of x squared minus 1 cubed. Okay, now there are two ways to see this problem. One is to go ahead and define it like this and to see g of x as this x squared minus 1 cubed and then take the derivative of that. You can do that. The other way is to use those properties of logs, so there's one. Another way is to use those property of logs and see f of x as 3 natural log x squared minus 1. In which case the 3 is just a constant multiplier, and it sits out front here while I take the derivative of this stuff right here. Right? And in this case, now when I define my g of x, it's simpler. G prime is 2x. Okay? So this is what I like when we're going through using these properties. It's one of these things where you can use them when you need to. Okay? So I'll use it here to make my life easier. So I get 3f prime of x is equal to 3, and then take the derivative of this, 1 over g of x times g prime of x, right? So that's 3, 1 over x squared minus 1 times 2x. So I get 3 times 2x over x squared minus 1. And finally, when I get the result, I'll get 6x over x squared minus 1. Okay? So either one of these methodologies will lead you to the same answer. So if you did it this other way here, that should also lead you to the exact same answer that we just got. Okay? But that's derivatives of logs. Please let me know if you have any questions.